options, and we wanted to spend more time in the demo itself to show you the integration and how our two solutions can integrate both with QuickBooks and also help each other out from an AR perspective. So agenda, we're just going to go into some introductions, and Tricia and myself will both be speaking to our different solutions right before we go into the demo. So a little bit about V Technologies. We specialize in integrated shipping solutions. That's all we do here in Connecticut. We've been in business since 89. We've been working with the Intuit solutions for the past 14 years. And we have a combined customer base, about 10,000 customers. You may know us better for our ShipGear solution, which is a middleware solution that works between carrier-supplied systems such as UPS WorldShip, FedEx Ship Manager, or Post Office, and QuickBooks. But Starship is kind of our upper-tier solution, so we're going to be highlighting that solution today. Starship is our multi-carrier, multi-mode solution, so it supports both parcel and freight shipments while giving you a host of other features that ShipGear doesn't quite offer. We are a gold developer for QuickBooks, and our solutions have been featured on the Slater Group's Awesome Add-on Awards. So a few high-level points on Starship. When you integrate Starship with QuickBooks, you do have a default interface that can connect to various QuickBooks sources, such as invoices, sales receipts, orders. But we also give you a nice interface to personalize the default maps and translations, so you have complete control over how fields come into Starship. When you're processing orders in Starship, you can either process a single one or you can also process a batch. Some of our customers will post their items on flash sale sites, so they'll want to quickly get out maybe 2,000 orders that of the same item that are going to various customers. So batch processing in that instance is a good solution for them. Starship does support, like I said earlier, multi-carrier, multi-mode, meaning both parcel and LTL. We also provide line item integration in the solution. That gives us the ability to automate LTL shipments, international, as well as EDI. So anything that requires a line item or commodity level detail, we can pull that information in. And we try to pull as much as we can from QuickBooks. But then we also fold in additional detail that may not be stored in your QuickBooks document to give you a more complete picture of your shipment. Rules-based processing, basically logic that allows you to automatically select carrier service or define how and when the freight gets updated. We'll show you a little more on that during the demo. Starship gives you the ability to create your own custom email notifications, so you don't have to use the carrier supplied emails anymore. You can actually add your own logo, your personalized message, information about the items that you're shipping, as well as the tracking numbers. For printouts, you have the ability to print what we call a smart label, which is a packing slip plus shipping label on an 8.5 by 11. You can also print both of those to a thermal label printer, or you can print a combination of laser and thermal. All Starship users will have access to the dashboard, and that just gives you the ability to search history, look at metrics, create reports. And then Starship also has integration with other solutions, such as Fishbowl and HighJump True Commerce for EDI. So if you do have those requirements, the Starship solution can grow with you. And this is just a visual of some of the carriers that we support. So we have quite a few LTL, direct LTL carriers, where we connect directly up to their servers to provide you access to rating and tendering and tracking. Okay, I'm going to hand it off to Tricia.
Hello, everyone, and again, thank you for joining us. My name is Trisha Hartigan, and I am with American Payment Solutions. Like the technologies, we focus on one thing, and we've been doing it for 25 years. So we focus on credit card processing, and we have thousands of merchants that are in the U.S. as well as Canada. We have a range of business sizes or monthly volume sizes, and they range anywhere from $2,000 a month up to $10 million a month. One of the things we're very proud about is our customer support team on site at our headquarters in Mesa, Arizona. And for any user of APS, they can pick up the phone and call. They don't have to fill out a ticket or wait in the queue. We have our folks there that are ready to assist. Another thing that we do offer, and I'll talk about a little bit more about this in a minute, is PCI compliance support. It's very important for anybody processing credit cards. And we have integrations with leading ERPs, including QuickBooks Pro, Premier, and Enterprise. So if you're on the phone and you take credit cards, you know there are a lot of challenges, not only in the credit cards, but with the processors sometimes. You may encounter confusing merchant statements, have crazy variable rates from month to month, charges for PCI compliance that are not clear, countless junk fees, expensive module or setup fees, and then unjustified fees for maintenance and support. What we do is we make sure your merchant statements are transparent, that you understand what you're being charged by the processor and the bank. Our rates are guaranteed. We don't fluctuate from month to month. Our PCI support is at no charge. We want to be sure you're PCI compliant. We don't have junk fees. We don't have fees for module or setup. And we have no fees for maintenance or support. We believe it's our duty as your processor to provide that support. When you're working with a processor, there's you can see on the screen, these are some things that we highly recommend you understand from your processor. Again, the PCI compliance that I talked about, this is established to protect credit card data, and you must be compliant if you're processing. So you don't want to incur those monthly fees because they can add up to hundreds of dollars a year. Merchant statements. If you can understand your merchant statement, if it's clear, if it tells you what fees you're being charged and why, you'll understand why those fees are due at the end of every month. Integrating with your ERP, obviously that saves you time. You don't have to re-key in information, and you avoid those costly mistakes as well as significant time. You also want to understand when and how your funds can become available. They can be available one day, 2 days, 3 days, but it's important to understand from your processor when your funds that you work so hard to earn will be available. And then there's cost savings programs that your processors can offer you. Level 2 and 3 processing works when you're accepting B2B or business credit cards or government cards and can offer cost savings. And then American Express has created a program called OptBlue for small to mid-sized companies that can save significant dollars on a monthly basis. So as I mentioned, we have integrations with Pro, Premier, and Enterprise. When you have that integration, the credit card numbers that you take are safely stored and encrypted in our vault. All of the data is tokenized, which simplifies that PCI compliance that's so very important. We auto-generate batch reporting, and it's emailed daily to whomever is indicated as the key recipient. We have secure 24/7 online transaction reporting. You can log into a portal at any time. I just mentioned the American Express OptBlue program. And then we have multiple address verification options, which obviously is very important in accepting credit cards. So we're going to do a demo now, and actually V Technologies happens to be a customer of American Payment Solutions. So we have that opportunity here to show you a fully integrated demo between Starship, QuickBooks, and American Payment Solutions. So Caroline is actually going to do the demo for you.
Great. Thanks, Tricia. So today what we're going to do is basically show you a complete workflow from, we're going to ship out an invoice document. Starship's going to update that, and then we're going to process the credit card transaction so that you can get paid on the invoice. So what you're looking at right now is our shipping screen. This would be the shipping screen that would replace, all those multiple applications that you may be running if you're running multi-carrier and you're looking to get everything into one user interface. Starship, in this upper left-hand corner, you're going to see the source. So I'm connected to my QuickBooks data right now. I do have the ability to ship against invoices, sales receipts, sales orders, or the customer list. So if you have samples that you want to ship that may not be associated to a QuickBooks document, you can select customers, and that way you can keep your shipping database clean and go off of your QuickBooks data, which should be the most accurate data that you have. I can also have different company connections. So Starship can connect to multiple QuickBooks companies, and for each QuickBooks company, it can have a different set of maps and translations. And as Tricia mentioned, with APS, we also integrate to the various flavors of QuickBooks Pro, or in the Starship side, we interface to QuickBooks Enterprise, and we're also going to be releasing a QBO interface in the near future here. So all I have to do here is I can either browse, scan, or enter the order number that I want to ship against or the invoice number. And this is also the area where you would be able to process multiple batches of invoices. In this case, I'm just going to select this particular invoice, and Starship is going to go out to the QuickBooks data and pull in the information. So in this left-hand pane here, you're going to see a preview of the header level information on the shipment. So you'll see that the carrier and service have been translated from the ship via. Billing type and accounts or associated information can also be translated if you'd like to do that to help automate that process. And then the recipient information here is pulling from the ship to on the invoice. Starship also has an address validation feature. It connects up to the post office database for ZIP plus 4 residential and commercial address validation. And then we have a secondary validation with both UPS and FedEx so that we can make sure that this residential flag is selected appropriately for those. Because those two carriers will sometimes consider the same address different from a residential commercial standpoint. I also just want to bring you down to the packaging view at the bottom of the screen. So what's happening here is Starship did grab the items that are on this invoice, and I'm actually using Starship's packaging scenario logic to auto-pack these items. So if you have case packs, where you always pack a specific quantity of any one item into a certain box, you can define that in Starship so that this information can come in pre-packed to help reduce the amount of entry that's happening by the shipper. Also make sure that you're calculating the appropriate dimensions here. So there were several changes that the carriers made in the past couple of years regarding dimensional weight. So putting the dimensions into the shipments becoming more and more important. And if you can get the dimensions associated to the item and to the box, that can be helpful. Starship, you can also rate shop. If I click on this rate shop button, Starship's going to go out to the various carriers and look to see what options I have for this particular shipment. So here you'll see that I'm looking at my contract charges, and I'm sorting them least expensive to most expensive way to ship the package. And I have a combination of UPS, FedEx, and post office showing here. Also with the post office, we do have a relationship with Parcel Partners and Indicia to provide discounted rates on priority shipments or express shipments. So that can save you as well. I'm just going to keep UPS ground here that came over from the ship via, and I'm going to process this shipment. So when I process the shipment in Starship, Starship will generate the barcoded shipping labels, and it'll try to write back, and it might have an error. Looks like my record's locked. Let's see. Might be open in this guy. So here's my packing list that's going to print out. It's going to be the smart label, which is a combination of the packing list plus the shipping label in an 8.5 by 11. This is going to be a little tear-off form. And in this case, I had two boxes, so I have two labels printing. So it looks like for some reason this order is already in use by somebody else who's connected to my QuickBooks. So if the invoice is up and available or somebody's actually editing it, Starship would not be able to update that. So let's go into my email viewer and take a look to see what Starship generated from an email perspective. I'm going to go in here. So this is the email that Starship generated. So unfortunately, it wasn't able to write back to QuickBooks, but it's still going to do all the other outbound things for you. It's going to generate the email. It's going to update the carrier supplied system. So in this case, you'll see I just have a little logo. I'm able to add variable fields. So in the subject, I can add the PO of this particular customer so that they can recognize a number there in the subject. And in the body of this email, you'll see a combination of package and item level detail. So that'll give your customers a better view of what you shipped, how you shipped them, and how they're packaged up. The other nice thing you can do here is send customers back to your site for repeat business, give them a discount. You have the ability to define as many templates in Starship as you want, and then you can define rules on how and when those templates are used. So if you have a case where you're drop shipping and the customer whom you're drop shipping for wants the email to look a certain way or have their logo being displayed in the email, you can add additional logic for situations like that. Now, Starship, I wanted to go back into QuickBooks here and show you what the update's going to look like. And, of course, since we're on this demo live with you guys, it didn't write back, but, of course, I do have a case where it did. So let's go in and take a look at another invoice so I can show you what it looked like as far as writing it back. Let's go into this guy here. So if somebody wasn't in the invoice, I would be able to update the invoice, and it would look like this. You'll see here that Starship is updating the item with the detail, the shipment detail in the body of the item as a comment, and then it can also update the freight amount here. Now, the freight charge can also include a customizable handling fee. Starship has standard functionality called freight rules that allows you to define how and when the freight gets updated. And those freight rules can have logic that's built on your QuickBooks fields. So if you want to base it on the order total or the invoice total, maybe you have certain rules where you give free freight for orders over $500 or something of that nature. You can create rules like that. And then you can also base this number on the list rate for the carrier or on your negotiated rate. So there's a lot of flexibility that you have with the freight rules. And also on the description here, you have total control over the fields that get updated here. This information can also get updated on the memo field if you don't want it to show in the body of the document. So you can define how you want the write back to look. Okay. So once we've actually shipped it and we have the freight charges going back, what I wanted to show you is how you're going to actually charge the customer so you can get paid on that invoice. So when you install the APS plugin, which is actually really simple to do, it takes a few minutes to do that, you're going to get this extra menu item under customers, and you can click on process sale from here. There's actually a few different places where you can access this gateway payment dialog. You can either do it from here or from sales receipts, you have access there too. So if you're just creating a sales receipt, and you want to quickly charge it, you can have a workflow that way, and it's pretty quick. So let's go into Peacock and take a look to see what we have. And it looks like I've already charged that one. Let's see if we have another one that we can take a look at. So here's Dunnings Pool Depot. You'll see here that when I select Dunnings, you're going to see all of my available documents that are outstanding. I could charge all of these guys, or I could simply just select one of them. And you'll see as soon as I select it that the amount is showing, a description here, and this will get also updated on the QuickBooks side, and then the payment information. So let me put a credit card in here. And my CVV code. And the other thing that you can do from here, which is cool, they have a customer vault. So Tricia mentioned this earlier. It's basically going to store all the credit card information on the APS side. And that way you don't have to keep everything stored inside of QuickBooks, so you can be PCI compliant. So if I just process this guy, the gateway will process the transaction. So it's actually going to charge the card at that point. And I can print the receipt, click OK here. And now the also your invoice gets updated with the information. What's this invoice? If we click on this and drill into this guy. The other thing that I wanted to show you is the, we wanted to go over the actual APS portal. So let's take a look at that. So this is the APS gateway. It's going to give you access to view the transactions, run reports from here. You could also, if you ever had to do a void or a refund, you can do it from here. But let's just go into transaction reports and take a look to see what we've charged for today. And if I go here, you'll see that my credit card sales have been approved. Here's my one for the Dunnings pool. I can drill into it and get all the details. I think that's all we had on the actual demo side. Tricia, did you have anything else that you wanted to mention regarding the APS piece?
No, I think you did a great job demonstrating that. And as Caroline said, it is very easy to install, and as you just saw, very easy to use with the integration with QuickBooks as well as with Starship.
Awesome. Yeah, Tricia, I did a better job demoing yours than I did mine. let's see. Let me put our contact slide up. And
Yeah.
Hey, you guys. This is Adrienne. Great presentation, hey, Adrienne. Caroline. I just slipped a poll up there for the audience. Well, I'm going to announce a few questions, and we'll flash your contact information. I just wondered if the audience could just take a moment to answer this poll. Are you currently using Starship shipping software and or APS merchants credit card processing? Click all that apply. So It's a multiple choice answer. If you're using Starship or APS, go ahead and click on those. Or if you're not, click on that third one. And let's see, we have quite a few questions here. If the credit card is being stored in APS Vault, how would we know that there is a credit card on file? Would anything show in QB? Thank you, Jennifer.
You did see, yes, it would show on the screen, and it would pop up right under the fields where you had entered the customer name. So it does give you that indicator.
And how does Starship differentiate from the QuickBooks Shipping Manager? Caroline?
Thanks, Adrian. Well, there's quite a few things that you probably saw today. I mean, there's one, the fact that you can actually translate ship vias, you can translate fields, you have access, entire access to the field maps and how those come into Starship. You can create branded emails. You can ship international shipments. We'll use those line items to help print the commercial invoice, the shipper's letter of instruction, any of those documents that need to, you know, go along with an international shipment. We're going to write back the information. In addition to writing back the information, we're also going to give you access to freight rules to define how and when you want to write those freight charges back. LTL support, integration to EDI, there's tons of things. If you are interested in, you know, having a one-on-one with us, we can definitely schedule something with you so that you can take a look and we can delve in a little bit further with regards to your specific needs.
And I'm sharing the results of our last poll on the screen. Looks like 100% of you aren't using either Starship or APS merchants, and 90% of the attendees voted. I'm going to go ahead and hide those results. I'm going to put one more poll up here. If we could just take one more poll and have the audience answer this one. Are you interested in learning more? Click all that apply. So if you're interested in learning more about Starship shipping software, APS merchants, credit card processing, or not at this time, we really appreciate your answers to these questions. And how could I get started with APS? Tricia?
The best thing to do is to actually send us your most recent merchant statement. From there, we can do a quick analysis and show you where we can save money, set up a call, and walk through that. If you'd like to learn more before doing that, we're going to show my contact information in a moment, and please don't hesitate to give me a call.
And I'm going to go ahead and close this poll out and share the results. It looks like 56% of you are interested in learning more about Starship. And 67% are interested in learning more about APS, and 33% not at this time. I'm going to hide these results so we can show that contact information again. And I just want to preface with the audience that I am recording this, and everyone will get a follow-up email with this contact information and the recording of this presentation. And I have another question here. How long does it take to switch to APS? Tricia?
Once we have your merchant statement and your application, to actually install our solution is very quick. We have some customers who choose to do it on their own, and we give them our user guide. And otherwise, we have one of our implementation specialists walk through it, and you can be up and running in less than half an hour.
And I'm not seeing any more questions at this time. So I just want to thank the audience again for taking time out of your busy day. It looks like we're finishing up pretty early here. Caroline, Tricia, did you have any further comments?
No, I just wanted to say thanks for taking the time to look at our combined solutions. You know, here at V Technologies, like Tricia mentioned, we do utilize APS, so we're very happy with them and happy that we can kind of show how our solutions can work together to help automate the entire workflow.
Awesome. Well, thank you, everybody. Thank you, Tricia. Thank you, Caroline and the audience. We really appreciate everybody's time. Take care. Have a great day.
Bye, ladies. Talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.